Ladies and gentlemen, and especially family and friends of Rosemary Johnson, tonight we celebrate Rosie's unique contribution to the Royal Philharmonic Society over two decades. Rosie joined an altogether different Royal Philharmonic Society in November 1998, and together with Chairman Tony Fell and later with Graham Sheffield, began a transformation that turned the Society into the creative, forward-looking organization that it is today. Rosie passionately believes that music is and should be for everybody. She has championed this through these awards and through myriad initiatives to support young musicians and composers, most recently RPS Women Composers, a project that I know she holds particularly close to her heart and that we are all very proud of. She wants everyone to have a chance and believes that those who are in a position of creative leadership have a duty to encourage inclusivity and diversity. I found that it's very hard to say no to Rosie. With her mix of incisive understanding, vision, and charm, and she has helped forge strong RPS partnerships with musicians, composers, orchestras, and ensembles, nationwide and internationally, and with broadcasters, including Classic FM and BBC Radio 3, as well as donors and sponsors. Two statistics to put Rosie's work in context. Over 170 works have been commissioned or co-commissioned by the Royal Philharmonic Society since the year 2000, compared to just 16 in the whole of the 20th century. Today, the Society supports over 100 young musicians annually. When Rosie joined, we worked with only a few, and in some years, none at all. On a personal level, Rosie is a wonderful friend. She has conviction and charm, and she is greatly respected. Rosie, as a token of our appreciation, we wanted to do something very special. So going forward, the RPS Wigmore Hall Apprentice Composer Scheme will be named in perpetuity in your honor. And we wanted... And we wanted another significant role model for women in classical music to add to our tribute and to present you appropriately with a rose bowl. So please welcome Dame Mitsuko Uchida and Rosemary Johnson to the stage.
Up here, I never know that I should be talking. And today I thought, I wouldn't have turned up today unless it were for Rosemary, because she has been so kind to me, and she has done so many good things. And every time I meet her, I speak to her, I talk to her, her love of music is oozing from every overworked poor, if I may say so. and it is for me such a reassuring thing. And I thought that Rosemary was going to be a fixture, a total fixture to the Royal Philharmonic Society. So I can't believe that she is going to leave us. But I hope she is going to continue doing some good work. And whoever gets her is so bloody lucky. But from my point of view, I just want to say thank you to Rosemary for everything she has done, but also for being so kind to me personally. Thank you so much.
Well, it's not fair, I haven't had to do this before. I'm really overwhelmed, particularly about the Wigmore Apprentice Composer, which is such a lovely scheme. And for this wonderful bowl, if someone has any goldfish, I will home them. Oh, it's really extraordinary. 20 years have gone in a flash, and things have changed. In 1998, the society I joined was a rather smaller, quieter affair in a rather dingy basement. But now, just like the two tiny children I left at home on that first day, and they're over there, RPS has grown up. It's more confident, purposeful, more ingenious, full of potential and more relevant by the year. I'm so proud of it. And James Murphy, I know you're going to take very good care of it for me. But I really couldn't at all claim responsibility for all that's happened. I've been so lucky to have the support and guidance of three exceptional chairmen. John's already mentioned Tony and Graham Sheffield, and of course John himself. And of our committed trustees and council members. And in the office, my brilliant tiny admin team has been a second family. Robin Sheffield, Shannon, Beethoven Bust, I'm looking at you. Being Philharmonic is to be music loving, and everything RPS does comes down to the generosity and the love of all of you. There are too many of you to name individually. So to all the musicians, I simply want to say thank you. What else can I say? You're just awesome. And to everyone who listened, who gave advice, who joined us in some fantastic projects, who miraculously found cash, who placed our commissions in concerts and broadcasts, and most importantly, to those of you who shared the belief that music is for everyone, that excellence in music does matter, and who helped make things happen.